Vapi has just released a native SMS integration with their agents, enabling texts to be sent from your agents and texts to be sent to your agents, receiving messages live on the call. If you're new to the channel, I'm Brendan Jowett. I'm based in Melbourne, Australia, and I've been running an AI automation agency, Inflate AI, for nearly 2 years. We build AI voice agents and have extensively tested all of the voice platforms, AI models, automation builders, etc. We know that this update saves a huge amount of time in the development process. And in this video, I'm gonna do a complete step-by-step walkthrough of setting up a Vapi AI voice agent and enabling the real-time communication with SMS. And trust me, it's a lot easier than you think. So here's a quick demo of what we're gonna be building in this video. Hey, I just received a text message. Thanks so much for that. I'm just going to send through a time that I would like to actually book the appointment to schedule through. Is that okay? Can I send that through?
Yeah, totally. Just send me the time you want and I'll get it all set up for you. No rush.
Okay. Just send the message. Let me know if you got that.
Got it. Which day are you thinking for that 3 p.m. appointment? Just want to make sure we lock in the right time for you.
Oh, yep. I'll just send that through as well.
Sounds good.
Well, with Vapi SMS, you can just text your voice agent. So here, I'm just gonna text it, transfer $300, $400 to James.
Your request to transfer $400 to James has been successfully processed.
So this right here is Vapi.ai. So Vapi, if you aren't familiar, is a voice agent builder platform. So this is where we're going to be putting together all of the different connections and platforms to build out a complete, fully fledged working AI voice agent. So that means we're going to be able to connect in our AI models from OpenAI. We're connecting in our speech models like 11 Labs, and we're connecting this all the way to Twilio, which is a phone provider. So we can get a complete solution built out here on the platform. So once you've got an account up and running, what you can do is go into the top left and click the Create Assistant button. Once you've done that, you're going to land on this little pop-up, which is going to allow you to create your agent and give it a name. So I'm just going to call this the Real Estate YouTube Demo. So I'm going to do this demo based on sort of a real estate example. Obviously, you can name this whatever you'd like and build out whatever you'd like, but I'm just going to use this as the demo. And I am going to select blank template. So I'm not going to use one of these templates at the bottom here. Although, if you would like to, you can do that as well. Once you've got that up and running, we'll hit Create Assistant, and it's automatically going to load us into this blank assistant right here. You will notice on the side, I do have two assistants, and this is just one I created earlier and I'll be referring to, but otherwise it's gonna land on this blank page right here. If you do wanna learn more about building these AI voice agents and understanding all of the settings about Vapi and some of the other platforms that are out there, I do have plenty of other videos that go much more in depth into all the settings and configurations here. But in this video specifically, I'm just gonna build out more of a basic agent and then really focus in on the SMS agent side of things. But the fundamental things that you need to know about building an agent is that what you have is a system prompt. So the system prompt is the main set of instructions that really guides and forms the entire personality and capabilities of the agent that you're building. And so once you just created this template, we're going to see here our system prompt says this is a blank template with minimal defaults. You can change the model, temperature, and messages. So this isn't really a prompt at all. This is just some static text. But what we can do when this is set up is just hit the talk to assistant button in the top right.
Hello.
Hey, is this a Vapi assistant?
Hello, I'm an AI assistant here to help with your questions and tasks. How can I assist you today?
No, I'm all good. I was just testing this out.
Great. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions or need assistance in the future. Enjoy exploring.
So it's good to go. It's all working right out the gate. You may need to add your credit card to the platform to get that working right away. But otherwise, this system is up and running. This the settings that it starts with makes it ready to use. But the main thing that we are going to focus in on is the system prompt. So for this example, I'm going to build out a real estate agent, and then we're going to go ahead and connect the SMS function to it to see if we can actually text to the agent live on the call. So I've just gone ahead and copied in a big long prompt right here. And this prompt is for a real estate agent. And so I can quickly walk through exactly what this prompt is and why it's structured the way that it is. Fundamentally, what we've built is sort of a real estate digital receptionist, virtual receptionist. This is sort of an inbound system that you would call in for. It would be for a real estate company, and you would just be talking back and forth with it about certain properties that are on their website or things about their services and whatnot. And so as you can see through this prompt, we've got was quite a bit to it, although it is still quite a basic prompt. So when you start to think about more complex voice systems, at the top here, we've got a few different sections. So we've got a role. The role shapes the personality, it shapes who this assistant is, and this really helps to give the assistant, the AI, a bit of context as to, you know, its existence and exactly what it should be doing at all times of the conversation. And so I've just said, your name is Emily, you're an AI digital receptionist for Blue Real Estate. Your role is to communicate with callers who inquire about our properties. That is super basic still. You could add even more to that to give it more context, but obviously this is a basic example. Then we've got a task, and the task is giving it a more aligned thing on what you should actually be doing. So your task is to answer any questions the caller has using the information provided to answer those questions. Below that, we've got an appointment booking function as well. So this is your second task, is to help book appointments. It's got a specific function for that. Don't worry about this function. This isn't actually connected. So if anything, I could actually delete that because we aren't using any functions to do appointment booking today. Below this, we have some context about the business. So this is more about the real estate agency. So it's a dynamic real estate agency known for its innovative approach. Just a bunch of blabble, generated this on ChatGPT. And then below this, we have some information about the properties. So just giving you some context as to what agent where we're talking to and referring to and what our conversation is going to be about. But you can obviously do this to whatever you like. So once you've got that up and running with your own system prompt, the other thing is just the first message. And so when you create a blank template, it'll just say hello, but we can obviously swap this to something more relevant. If you want to say, hello, how can I help you today? That's more aligned with an inbound assistant and what would be said if you're calling into a number. But once again, you can do this whatever you like, and this is not critical for setting up the text side of things. So I'm going to go ahead and hit publish in the top right corner, and we can just give it a call to see if it actually works.
Hello, how can I help you today?
Hey, I was looking at your website and was just interested in one of the properties that you've got in California.
Hey there. Yeah, the Malibu spot's pretty sweet. It's got 4 bedrooms, 4 bathrooms, a gourmet kitchen, private beach access, and killer ocean views. Are you thinking about checking it out in person?
Yeah, potentially. We just wanted to know what your sort of terms were for heading over there and giving it a visit.
Gotcha. So usually we set up a time that works for you to swing by and take a look. No big deal, just a quick appointment to show you around and answer any questions. When would you want to come by? Like, what day and time works best for you?
Nothing at the moment. I will still have to check with the family about that one. Do you have any availability for some time next week?
Yeah, next week's pretty open. Just let me know what day and time your family's good with, and I'll lock it in for you. No rush at all.
So there we have it. Works pretty great out of the gate there. I did go ahead and actually swap the model over to GPT 4.1 mini. If you watched my previous video, you would know all about these new models. So I do recommend going ahead and checking that video out. 4.1 mini is quite a good model in terms of cost and speed and intelligence, and works really well for a prompt that isn't too complicated and is a use case that can be quite easily understood. And so definitely check out that video if you want to learn more about those new models. But otherwise, let's go ahead and connect this into our tools. So one of the key parts of building these voice agents is the tools. Combined with the prompt and the tools, they're really the two main things that you need to focus on when building out these voice agents. And one of the really awesome new updates that's come out from Vapi is the fact that they have automatically built out a native integration with SMS. And so if you click on the tools function, so clicking on the tools at the top of the screen here, coming down and you'll see the tools section. If we click into here and we click create new tool, we're going to land on this page. And so I've got the send text tool at the moment. This is one that I created out previously. So what I can do is just delete this because we aren't going to be using this. If I just click the create tool button, I go all the way down to send text. This is a new function that's built out specifically by Vapi for this use case. And so we can very easily hit the send text tool right there. And this is what's going to pop up. And so this tool is something that we can leverage on any of our agents to send and receive texts live on the call. So this is pretty awesome and it works really smooth. And so once this is set up, there's not a whole lot that we need to do in terms of configuration. If I come down here and see the settings and the from phone number, we can just click into here and select our Twilio number. So obviously you do need to connect your system to a phone number. And in order to utilize this SMS automation, you do actually need to connect your phone number first. So sign up for Twilio and import a number and you can use it. Unfortunately, we can't use a Vapi number. So if you've imported a number through Vapi, unfortunately, we can't use that one. For SMS, you do need to upload a custom number from Twilio for that. If you aren't sure how to do that, there are plenty of videos out there. It's not that hard at all. What you need to do is just head over to the phone number section of Vapi, click on create phone number. You'll see a bunch of settings pop up here. So you'll see that there's the free Vapi number. This is not going to work with the SMS. So I wouldn't use this if you wanted to do that. There's the free Vapi SIP. Once again, you wouldn't want to use this because it's not going to be able to connect to Twilio. The main section is import Twilio. And so in this case, what you need to do is create an account on Twilio. You need to grab your account SID, which is sort of like a username, and then authentication token, which is sort of like a password for your account. So you add in those details and then you'll get access to all of the phone numbers that you've purchased. And then as long as the phone number that you've purchased has text enabled for that specific number, then you're going to be able to use it. So just make sure that that is one thing that you will need to do to get this up and running. But otherwise, that's a pretty streamlined process to do. And once that's connected, you should be good to go. So coming back to our assistant now, we go back up to the tools. We do need to then assign that tool to our agent for it to actually be able to utilize it. And we'll just hit publish. Now that we've done that, you do obviously want to finally make sure that your phone number itself is also connected to your agent. So obviously, if you're going to be being called by this agent and then you want to have a text conversation, you will want to obviously be able to text that specific number that's connected to the agent. So make sure that's connected as well. But once that's done, it's pretty much ready to go. So before we get started in testing this system out, there is one thing that I do want to add into our system prompt to really ensure that this works really smoothly. And the one thing that we're going to add is just a little bit of prompting to give it context to understand that it actually has the ability to send and receive text messages. So it will work if we just add the tool, although it won't be as smooth working. It won't work every single time because it doesn't have the full context as to what it's doing in the conversation. And so we can really simply solve this by typing a little bit of a prompt. So we can just say, you have the ability to send and receive text messages using the send message tool, or we want to get the exact tool name for that. So it's send text tool. We'll just add that in there. So using the send underscore text tool, and we'll just write that. You have the ability to send and receive text messages using the send text tool. So literally, that is all we really need to do for now to get it a bit better than obviously not having it at all. And that's just going to allow us to have more context in the conversation. In some cases, it'll work. Some cases, it won't if you don't add that into the prompts. But just to stay safe, definitely add that in.
I help you today.
Hey, I was looking at one of your properties in New York. We're really interested in learning a little bit more about it.
Oh, cool. The Midtown Manhattan place? It's a one bedroom, one bathroom spot with a modern kitchen and high end appliances. Plus it's got great city views, a doorman, fitness center, and it's pet friendly. What else do you want to know?
No, that's awesome. Would you rather just send through in a text some of those details to me so I can save them for later?
Sure thing. Just let me know your phone number and I'll send the details right over.
Yeah, so my phone number is hey, I just received the text message. Thanks so much for that. I'm just going to send through a time that I would like to actually book the appointment to schedule through. Is that okay? Can I send that through?
Yeah, totally. Just send me the time you want and I'll get it all set up for you. No rush.
Okay, just sent the message. Let me know if you got that.
Got it. Which day are you thinking for that 3 p.m. appointment? Just want to make sure we lock in the right time for you.
Oh, yep. I'll just send that through as well.
Sounds good.
Did you get that? I just sent it through.
All right. Monday at 3 p.m. Yep, I got that you want to book for Monday at 3 p.m. I'll go ahead and set that up for you. Anything else you want to add or ask?
No, that's perfect. Could you just send through in the same text message just a booking confirmation?
Yeah, I can do that. I'll send you a quick text confirming your Monday 3 p.m. appointment. Just a sec.
Perfect. Just received it. Thank you.
Awesome. Glad you got it. If you need anything else or want to chat more about properties, just hit me up. Have a great day.
So there you have it. That is how to connect an SMS to send and receive text messages live on the call with Vapi. Now, one thing to note is that on that call, I did actually have to give it my phone number in order to know who to send the text message to, although through custom variables in your specific prompt, you could actually just send through the number that's calling in for. So in that case, would have been my number, and you could actually add that into the prompt. And so you could essentially prompt it to say, if anybody calls in, have the text messages automatically sent to that number, or just assume to send it to that number. And then that way you can make it a bit more conditional, a little bit smoother, but otherwise it is quite good at capturing phone numbers as well. And it worked clearly in that instance, and it did exactly what we wanted it to. If you've got any other questions about Vapi, about setting up automations, or anything to do with AI and automations, I've got my free school community linked in the description. We've got almost 10,000 members now who are happy to help out with any of your questions.